Okay, let's get serious. Let's talk about the tropics. A couple systems I'm not concerned about way in the central Atlantic, low chances. We're really talking about, and this is the main focus of 40% of possible development, Caribbean, Yucatan Channel, Southern Gulf. But that's 7 days, so it's a long, long time from now. Forecast data out of the U.S., we go through the weekend, we get into next week. There still doesn't look like a lot of organization here. But through the Yucatan Channel in this forecast afternoon, this is good for us. It stays away. That's bad for Tampa, though. Another forecast out of Europe. This forecast is much different. Take a look at this. Little to no organization through the weekend, but it takes the energy through the Yucatan Peninsula, possibly Bay of Campeche. So you see here a big difference between storms Florida, storms to the southwestern Gulf. Listen, the steering pattern I showed, one potential is the Bermuda High catches that system, and that's what our forecast out of the U.S. says and interacts with a system dropping through the U.S., drives it our way. The forecast out of Europe, saying more of a high that's over the western U.S. takes hold. But what I'm starting to see is some potential our forecast data digging the jet stream down, cutting off these systems, and these systems just spinning around on their own. These are cutoff lows, and what that signals is that's a really, really uncertain forecast. Anytime you have systems not connected to anything and they help to drive the forecast, well, listen, a lot of variability in the forecast. What that tells us is we got a long way to go and the forecasts are still all over the board. I've got a blog, WDSU.com, keeping you up to date with the latest info, analysis. It's there, updating every day.